Hello everyone, welcome to the Shivah, Kosher Edition, an adventure game about a Jewish rabbi at a poor synagogue in New York City, made by Wadjet Eye Games. I want to thank David, one of my viewers, for telling me about this game. So the Shivah, that is the non-kosher edition, was actually the first game that Wadjet Eye Games made, and just recently they decided to remake it, and that is the edition you see here now, Shivah, Kosher Edition. Is completely remade, it has new music and new graphics and a bunch of other improvements and changes. Wadjet Eye Games is actually responsible for developing the Blackwell series and for publishing Gemini Rue, which are actually some of my favorite adventure games of all time, so I'm really looking forward to trying this out. It's going to be an interesting look kind of into their past. It's going to be a partial look into their past because it is the first game they made, but at the same time it's also... because it's been remade, it now has a lot of the new skills that they've developed over time. So it's kind of a look at their past and also kind of not. Either way, it should be interesting. So this game is available on Steam, and I believe on their main site as well, and maybe from other places too. I'm not sure about any other places off the top of my head, but I'll have links to all of that in the description for where you can play it for yourself and check it out. One thing I definitely want to mention is that I don't know really much of anything about Judaism or Jewish practices or Jewish anything. I just don't know. I'm probably going to be scratching my head a lot. I hope knowledge of like Jewish practices and stuff is not too important to playing the game, because if it is, I'm going to totally fail. We'll see what happens. And, as usual, I like to analyze and think about the games I play, so I'll be analyzing a bit as I go through it, and especially towards the end. And I think that's all there is to mention. Let's go, new game. It began, as many things do, with a song.
Adon Olam Asher Malach Baterem Ko Yitzir Nivra Lied Nasa V'chel Tzoko Atzai Melech Shemo Nikra.
His final note faded off into the near-empty synagogue, unheard by anyone. As I had hundreds of times before this, I got ready to speak. And, as I had hundreds of times before this, I began to wonder why.
Thank you, Cantor Kaplan. Today in my sermon, I'd like to discuss suffering. Why do bad things happen to good people? Wherever there is pain or oppression or poverty, the question is always the same. How could God let this happen? Is God as good as we think? Can he, in fact, do evil? Maybe, on occasion, he even enjoys inflicting pain. I
took a good hard look around my world. And then it hit me.
No. I can't do this. I'm sorry.
Rabbi?
You heard.
Huh? What?
Go home, Mrs. Raymer.
Is it over already?
Yeah.
Rabbi Stone, wait! You can't just stop.
Sure I can. Just watch me.
But...
it's over, Josh.
You can't mean that.
Look, you're a good kid. You've got a good voice and a good future. Don't let me hold you back. Now do a mitzvah and call Mrs. Raymer a cab. Goodbye, Josh.
Ethical dilemmas have plagued religious leaders since the dawn of time. But morals don't mean crap without the personal experiences to back them up. Who the hell is that? Alright, so as we can see so far, the synagogue is not doing too well. There's apparently no one here but one person who was sleeping. Just go away.
Go away. I said, go away.
Fine, who is it?
Fine, I'm coming. I thought I told you to go home.
Rabbi Stone, there's someone here.
Tell him to get lost. There's no service tonight.
No, it's a cop.
Huh?
Detective Sam Durkin. Midtown South Precinct. Could I talk to you for a few minutes, Rabbi Stone?
Okay, sarcastic poker face? Or rabbinical response? What is a rabbinical response? I guess you would respond as a rabbi would. The only thing is, I don't know how rabbis normally respond. I've never talked to one. Rabbinical response.
Is there some sort of problem, officer?
I'd just like to ask you a few questions.
Fine. Josh, take a hike. So, what can I do for you? I assume you're not here to convert.
Are you familiar with a Mr. Jack Lauder?
Should I be?
I'm asking the questions, Rabbi.
Fine. Let me think. Lauder. Lauder. Oh.
You know him?
Yeah.
What can you tell me about him?
He used to belong to this congregation.
Used to? But not anymore?
No. Left about 8 years ago, I think. What's this about?
Have you had any contact with him since?
No, I haven't. Care to fill me in here?
Do you read the papers?
Okay, he's a cop. I'm just gonna be honest here.
Not recently.
So, you're not aware, Rabbi Stone, that Jack Lauder has been dead for 3 days?
I did my best to control myself. I knew this man's type. His eyes scanned my face like a barcode reader, trying to read every telltale sign of emotion. Any flicker, any twitch, could be used against me later.
No.
Does that bother you?
Should it?
Answer me, Stone.
No.
So, you and Mr. Lauder weren't close?
No, we weren't. What's the deal, Durkin?
I've seen Lauder's will. He left you a significant amount of money.
Oh. That's just the thing a poor synagogue needs. Really?
He did what?
You heard.
How much?
I don't have the exact amount, but somewhere in excess of 10,000.
Bull.
It's the truth.
Jack wouldn't give me bubkis, let alone $10,000.
And why is that, Rabbi Stone?
He just wouldn't.
Huh. This temple's in pretty sad shape, isn't it, Rabbi?
Well, you're not blind, that's for sure.
Can you afford the repairs?
I think I'm just gonna keep going with rabbinical response, because it sounds awesome.
Do I look like I can afford it?
I'm just asking.
Oh, you're just asking? Well, I'm going to ask you to leave. Don't let the door hit you on the way out.
Rabbi Stone.
Get out of my office.
Listen.
No, you listen. I know where this is going, and I don't like it.
I'm just doing my job.
Yeah, you're a real mensch. Get out of here.
Fine. I'll leave, Rabbi Stone. But I'll be back.
Yeah, I bet you will.
Butts. The rain beat in a regular staccato rhythm against the window. But I could only hear one thing. Jack Lauder. Jack Lauder. The name pulled out a cork in my brain, letting loose old thoughts and memories that fought and struggled for supremacy. Jack Lauder. It was more than just a name. It was a link to a time when things were simpler. A time when I thought I had it all figured out. A time when morals and ethics meant something. A time before it all turned to crap.
I need to think.
Around $10,000 left to someone who didn't even seem to really... or left by someone to someone that neither of them really seemed to even know each other. Move your mouse to the top of the screen to access your inventory and menu. Thank you. Yiddish dictionary. And a business card. Rabbi Russell Stone. B'nai Ben Zion? No. I even have an email address. Rabbi Stone. At rafnetnewyork.com. Oh, it defines what all these things mean. Okay, that is cool. All right. Wait a minute. Meshuggah. Crazy. Isn't that the name of a metal band? Meshuggah? Or is that... isn't that the name of a band? I think it is. Huh. Mensch. A helpful person. Mumser. Bastard. Son of a bitch. Nebbish. Weakling. Shiva. Period of mourning. Shixi? Shix? Non-Jewish woman. Yenta? A busybody. Goy? Non-Jewish person. Huh. There we go. Just read that dictionary. Now I know everything about Judaism. Yep. That... I'm not sure what year this is set in, but that is a sorry-looking computer if this is set in the modern time. Simply by the fact that it's a CRT. Anything with a CRT monitor is officially ancient, in the year of 2013. I can actually use it! Josh set this computer up a few weeks ago. He claimed I needed to join the 21st century and connect with the community. Josh has been bugging me to start using it. I suppose now is as good a time as any. If only I could remember what Josh chose as my login and password. This is like the first puzzle is logging into my own computer because I'm so incompetent that I don't even know the password to my own computer. Oh my god. Ravnet, New York, where Jews connect. I don't know. Rabbi Stone? Sorry, there is no user with a login, Rabbi Stone. Ah, forget it. Stupid thing. See, this is why I don't like computers. You have to log in and there's like security. What were they thinking? It was fine where it was. I'm assuming it's right click to examine? Yes. A color photograph of a B'nai Ben Zion youth group picnic. It was taken over 15 years ago. Most of those kids probably had families of their own by now. It's always a strange thought, isn't it? When you see an old picture and you think, the people in this photo are, you know, they're adults, or maybe they have families, or maybe they're even so old that a lot of them have died. It's so strange. This window afforded me the thrilling view of the deli across the street. Diploma, poster, certificate. My diploma from B'nai B'rith Yeshiva.
Has it really been 30 years?
30 years? That's a long time. I had come across this quote some years ago, and had decided to have it printed and mounted on the wall. It read, if statistics are right, the Jews constitute but 1% of the human race. It suggests a nebulous, dim puff of stardust lost in the blaze of the Milky Way. Properly, the Jew ought hardly to be heard of, but he is heard of, has always been heard of. Mark Twain, 1899. My certificate? Our certification of rabbinical studies. It reads, this is to certify that Russell Elijah Stone has been granted the title of Rabbi by B'nai B'rith Yeshiva on the date of June 23rd, 1970. Possible password? I'm gonna write that down. Just bills. Lots of them. And can't even pay the bills, let alone pay for repairs to this sorry place. That's depressing. Why is there a ladder leading up to a crawl space? Am I gonna pull a Half-Life? Am I gonna pull a Gordon Freeman? A small crawl space used to store old records. There is nothing up there I wanted to see. These boxes contained a small supply of... Do I pronounce it like a K? Is it Kiddush wine or is it Yiddish? You pronounce it with a Y? I don't know. Kiddush wine doesn't sound right, but maybe it is. As much as I would have loved to break open a bottle of Kiddush wine, I didn't think it was appropriate. True enough. My collection of rabbinical texts, prayer books, Judaic history, and Harry Kemmelman novels. Let's go speak to whatever his name was. What was the kid's name?
Wow, Rabbi, what was that all about?
I'm tempted to go with a rabbinical response just to be a smartass. Yeah, I'm gonna do that.
Didn't I tell you to go home?
Come on, Rabbi, I have to know. Who was killed?
Josh, what did I tell you about listening at my door?
I wasn't, Rabbi, honest. You were just... very loud.
Huh.
So who was killed? Was it that Lauder guy?
How exactly did he know? I guess he must have heard the name. Rabbinical response, as always.
Do you think so?
Yeah. Who else could it be? I heard you talking about him.
Huh. We must have talked very loud.
Well, yeah. So who is he?
An old member of this congregation.
Ah, that's too bad.
Yeah, well, it happens to the best of us.
Are you gonna pay a Shiva call?
I don't think there will be a Shiva, Josh.
Why?
Shivas are for Jewish families. Just forget it.
All right, if that's what you want. I guess I'll go now.
Yeah. Good night, Cantor.
Night, Rabbi.
$10,000. Less than 20 minutes ago, I had accepted defeat. The bank was going to foreclose on the property, and there was nothing I could do. Jack's money changed all that. The B'nai Ben Zion Synagogue could remain open. I wouldn't have to see my life's work turned into a shopping mall or a parking lot.
Has God answered my prayers?
The age-old question. What is the work of God, and what is the work of man? The money was a boon, there was no doubt about that. But it was blood money, and I couldn't believe God would work that way.
I don't like it. Not one bit. Why, Jack? Why me? Why now?
They say God helps those who help themselves. And I had done absolutely nothing to get this money. I didn't trust it. Suddenly, the cantor's words came back to me.
A Shivah call. I can't just barge in unannounced, but I can pay a Shivah call. It's the only way.
Right-click and hold to show all items on screen. I'm doing that, but it doesn't seem to be working? It doesn't seem to be working. Strange. But anyway, okay, is it pronounced Shivah or Shiva? Because I pronounced it Shiva. I guess it's Shiva. Let's see if I can actually remember that. Right. So I'm gonna pay a Shivah call. That is a good excuse to go examining exactly what has been going on. Should I get onto my computer now? I probably should. But what's the login? I might have the password, but I need the username, right? What would it be, just Russell Stone? I did spell that correctly, right? Or did I? Two S's, two L's. Maybe I didn't. Not a Y. Nope. Rabbi Russell... No. Nope. I don't know. I have no idea. I don't even know if I need to do that yet. So maybe I shouldn't worry about it. You know, it seems to be my curse that in adventure games I get stuck in like the first room with some stupid little puzzle. And it just takes me forever to solve it. And I have a feeling the same thing is going to happen. Lectern. A sturdy, dependable podium. Perfect for pounding during less successful sermons. Pound it to get their attention. This cabinet was converted into a makeshift Torah ark after the last one was stolen in 1996. The cantor's lectern contained his prayer book and song notations. Oh, we have a map. Manhattan Isle. I think it's the only place to go, right? This is a very strange looking map. I don't even know what I'm looking at. Just like blobs of blackness. Okay, so I need to figure out the computer, don't I? I do, don't I? It's so strange that the right-click thing is not working to show items. Oh, it does work, you just have to hold it for a really long time. Like, 2 or 3 full seconds. Okay. Well, I didn't miss anything. Ben Zion, maybe? Username? I can't see my keyboard, by the way, because of the way I have my setup going when I'm recording, so that's why it's kind of hard for me to type. Okay, this is going to take me 5 million years, probably, so I'm just going to cut, and I'll come back to when I figure out what the login is. Oh, you know what it probably is? It's probably R. Stone. Right? Because it's rstone@ravnetnewyork.com. Yeah, it's probably R. Stone. Bingo, please enter your password. There's even a clue button. Nah, I don't need that. Okay, well, it's probably that date, the date when I became a rabbi, I believe that was. June 23rd, 1970. Let's just try the year. Oh, I gotta go back to the login. Okay, in that case, let's try June, 6 for June, 23, 1970. No, okay. Let's just try 23, 1970. Oh, wait, no, hold on. Alright. Need more information. It's not 6/23/1970, it's not 1970, and it's not 23/1970. So what is it? I'm looking for numbers. It doesn't have to be in numbers, though. That's the thing, passwords don't have to be numbers. Let's look around again.
Has it really been 30 years?
Okay, if it's been 30 years, then I guess it's around the year 2000? Yeah, June 23rd. Well, I already tried that for the password. It seems like the most obvious one for the password, but it doesn't work. ''1899, maybe? The year of the quote? 1899? Maybe the password's Mark Twain. Let's try that. I have to say, I really love it when an adventure game makes you, or has you, write down stuff. Like when you need to write down stuff for an adventure game. I really like that. Something I really like about having to actually write down information to solve puzzles. Let's look at everything. And right click. Right click. There we go. What else would have something that could be a password? Maybe B'nai Ben Zion? No, that's a stupid password, though. Alright, let's try a couple things. There we go. So, 1899. Nope. Mark Twain! Not Stain. Twain. There we go. I'm gonna beat you, computer. I'm gonna beat your puzzle. It's really not June... What could it be? There's so little. See, again, I told you the curse of the opening puzzle in an adventure game for me. I'm cursed. I can never solve the opening freaking puzzle. And this is exactly that. But look at this. This seems to indicate to me how many characters you need to enter. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Which is the exact amount that the date would have when I got my rabbinical certificate of rabbinicalness or whatever. June 23rd, 1970. That is 4, 5, 6, 7 digits, but it doesn't work. Which is again, 6/23/1970. Day, month, year, maybe? 23/6/1970. have to log into the user again. Okay, I'll be back when I solve this. Okay, I finally, after spending like 5 or 10 minutes just trying stuff, I clicked on the clue button and it said, "Your password clue is a busybody." Or busybody, rather. Which I guess is a yenta, according to my Yiddish words dictionary. So is that the password, yenta? How was I supposed to get that? Was I supposed to just try random Yiddish words, or... I don't even know. Okay. Let's get a joke. I don't know how to pronounce that. Moshi? Mosh? Probably Moshi. Moshi was talking to his psychiatrist. "I had a weird dream recently," he said. "I saw my mother, but then I noticed she had your face. I found this so worrying that I immediately awoke and couldn't get back to sleep. I just stayed there thinking about it until 7 a.m. I got up, made myself a slice of toast and some coffee, and came straight here. Can you please help me explain the meaning of my dream?" The psychiatrist kept silent for some time, then said, "One slice of toast and coffee. Do you call that a breakfast?" What? Let's try again. Martin Lewis converts and becomes a priest. He gives his first mass in front of a number of high-ranking priests who came for the occasion. At the end of the new priest's sermon, a cardinal goes up to congratulate him. "Pastor Lewis," he said, "that was very well done. You were just perfect. But next time, please don't start your sermon with fellow Goyim." I don't get it. I know Goy is a non-Jewish person according to the Yiddish dictionary, but... I mean, I kind of get it, but I don't... So, I think it went over my head. I get it, but I don't get the joke. Oh well. Let's check my mail. Oh, whoa. From admin at Revnet, blah, blah, blah. Welcome to Revnet. Revnet. Mazel Tov! Welcome to Ravnet New York, the newest way to bring Jews together as a community. Our features are small but growing. Here's a list of what we currently offer. The mail feature allows you to send and receive email. The search feature allows you to search our data archives of Jewish news, events, and members. Everyone needs a laugh. Check out our joke feature for the best in Jewish jokes. On behalf of myself and the entire Ravnet team, thank you for joining and making our community stronger. It's a test from Jay Kaplan. Hello, Rabbi Stone. I set up your account for you. Hopefully it'll work out okay for you. You can change the password if you want. Most people choose things like their mother's or their wife's maiden name, but I thought this was appropriate. Cantor Josh. It was. It was appropriate, although I'm not sure how I was supposed to get it. Something Schwartz? At cheapmail.com, shocked. Dear Rabbi Stone, I have been a loyal member of B'nai Ben Zion for many years, but I can't bring myself to listen to your dark and gloomy sermons any longer. Times are tough enough for us Jews without you rubbing salt in the wound. Goodbye. Lisa Schwartz. I guess his attitude that I just saw at the beginning of this game is, well, it's probably been going on for a while, as you can imagine. With his synagogue just in disrepair and unable to pay the bills and low attendance. I guess things have been going badly for a while and is driving people away. Dave at Wadjet Eye Games. Great games. It's an advertisement for the developers of the game. Self-advertising, you bastards! It's fine. Jbrooks at hotmail.com, what happened? I'm sorry, but my family and I can't attend your services any longer. Your last few sermons have upset the children so much that it took several hours to calm them down. What happened to you? Jeremy Brooks. Oh my God, there's so many! Tomo, special offer. At undisclosed email. That's shady. For your network protection needs, contact Tomo. Wait a minute, hold on. This seems familiar. Was this not an email that you got in one of the Blackwell, or maybe all of the Blackwell games? This seems so familiar, Tomo. And I still don't know what it means. Weird. Manager at electric.com, final notice. Due to continuing non-payment, your electrical service will be terminated if the overdue balance of $525.67 is not met by April 21st. Contact our office if you have any questions. Wow, the power is about to be shut off. Things are getting bad. Sapple at vacco.net. Rabbi Stone, I've tried to have faith in you, but it's obvious that you are becoming increasingly more unbalanced. You call yourself a Jew? Our people need leaders. Regretfully, Sarah Applebaum. Man, people are just leaving in droves. Overdraft notice. This is to inform you that your account is currently $1,800, almost $1,900, into its overdraft. As you are aware, your account only has $1,000 of overdraft protection. Please submit the difference of $890, yip, 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 to us within 7 days so as to not damage your credit rating. Damn, I really, really need the money. Okay. So, I guess I should find information on Jack Lottam's death. It was Jack Lottam, right? Like, spelled like that? Yes, I think. Maybe not. How is his name spelled? Jack? Deaths? Money? Tell me about money? Help me? No. No help. I'm assuming I do need to search for his name, right? But what was it? Where would I find his name? I think it was like Jack Lottam, I'm just not sure how to spell it. It's not gonna be in my dictionary, that's for sure. Is there like a quest log? Jack Lottam. I don't know, maybe I can leave now? I doubt it. I don't really have a mission. I mean, I know I need to investigate him. To investigate where this money is coming from, exactly why it's coming here. But to do that, I need to know where to go, and I don't imagine I know where he lives. And yeah, there's nowhere else to go. How did you spell his name? Oh, I have to log in again. What was the password? Yenta? Yeah. Um Right, so you can search their data archives of Jewish names, events, and members. What the hell, let's get a joke. Screw it. Medical experts from London have published a paper that concludes that participants should not eat both chopped liver and... I don't even know what these things are. Seder? What is that? Cirrhosis? What? The research shows that if they do, it can lead to... cirrhosis of the liver. That went so far over my head, it's not even funny. Moisha walks into a post office to send a package to his wife. The postmaster says, "This package is too heavy. You'll need another stamp." Moisha replies, "And that should make it lighter?" That's so stupid. It's terrible. That's terrible. Lauder? Laudum? What was it? Jack something. Oh, Jack Lauder! Are you supposed to just remember his name? What if I didn't? Would you have had to restart the game and write it down or something? Brutal. Contact information. Oh, I'm gonna write this down just in case. Maybe I need to remember it forever or I'll never be able to access it again. Lauder, 100 Jane Street. Apartment 4E. Got it. Jack Lauder of Beth Tikva was found dead last night in his Midtown office. Victim of an apparent assault by person or persons unknown. We at Ravnet express our sympathies to Jack's friends and family. Hold on, I'm curious about something here. This says that you can search for other, like, Ravnet members. Or other members of the Jewish community. So what if I get someone's name who's definitely in the community? Like... you. Cantor Josh. Actually, that's not really his first name, right? Isn't Josh his first name and Cantor is his position? I still want to try searching for it anyway. Cantor Josh. And let's try someone else's name, just to see if you can get information on some other people, just, I don't know, for the fun of it. Let's try Lisa Schwartz. Alright. Not Hosh. Nope. I don't imagine Josh is going to give me anything. No. Let's try Lisa Schwartz. No, okay. Time to go. Time to go pay a visit. With the excuse of it being a Shivah. This is a very strange map. In fact, it's so strange it honestly, it... I'm not joking when I say this map looks corrupted. Like, this looks like a corrupted image. It looks like this is broken. And it's not displaying correctly. I don't even know what I'm looking at. It's just blobs of black and white and weird glows. What? It doesn't look right. But it's functional, which is the most important part. Greenwich Village, Lauder Residence. That's a very nice place, look at that. Incredibly polished floors as well.
Mrs. Lauder?
Yes?
I heard about your husband. I came to pay my respects.
Oh, you knew Jack?
I'm not gonna lie. No. I'm just gonna be honest.
Some time ago, yes.
All right, come on in. I'm sorry, you look so familiar, but I can't place your face. What is your name?
If I wanted answers, she'd have known who I was. This required tact. Okay. I'm just gonna continue to be honest.
My name is Rabbi Russell Stone. Your husband used to be a member of my congregation.
Oh, I remember now. You have a lot of nerve coming here.
I was worried about that. Because when Russell said that there's no way that Jack would have given him money, the way he said it made it sound as if they hated each other, like Jack didn't like Russell. And apparently he didn't, judging by her reaction. Well, look, whatever happened before, whatever bad blood existed between them, it's long in the past. And he's dead now. Just put it behind us.
Well, I'm sorry about that.
Oh, you're sorry, are you? I'm so glad to hear that. Jack would love to hear that you are sorry.
He knows already, Mrs. Lauder.
Too late, Rabbi. Too late. What do you want?
Money? I mean, no. Don't say that. I'm just gonna keep going with honesty. Direct.
I just want to talk about Jack.
Talk? Just came by for a friendly chat? Is that it? Oh, stop it. Just stop it. I don't believe this. You threw us out of your temple 8 years ago. And now you drop by for a visit?
It wasn't like that.
Well, what was it then? Can you tell me that?
Maybe this was a bad idea.
Maybe you're right. And yet you're here. Why?
Direct approach, once again.
The police visited me today.
Did they?
Yes.
What did they say?
That I'm suspect number one.
Really? Well, that would make sense. Who else has a motive except for the rabbi who hates us?
Do you really think I would kill him? Rabbinical.
Why do you think I hate you, Mrs. Lauder?
Enough! Do you have to do that here? Now? There is a time and a place, Rabbi, and this is not it.
Look, I don't hate...
Whatever. Jack hated you. That's enough.
Mrs. Lauder, if he hated me so much, why did he leave me $10,000 in his will?
That's impossible.
I said the same thing.
Jack wouldn't do that.
It's a crazy world.
How do you know for sure?
The police told me. I have no love of the police, but I doubt they'd lie about that. Mrs. Lauder, if Jack hated me so much, why did he give me so much money?
I don't know. This makes no sense. None of it does. Who would kill Jack? He was a good man.
Yes, he was.
Don't you start. You have no idea.
The police have no other leads?
Aside from you? No.
How did he die?
I don't see how that's any of your business.
I suppose I'm curious, and I'd like to help.
Help? Why would you want to help?
I don't know. Maybe I...
Well, it's certainly not because I'm selfish. It's because I don't want to just take the money without knowing why it's left to me, because it doesn't make any damn sense why he would leave it to me. I need to know. I feel guilty taking this money from someone who apparently I threw out. I don't know why. I mean, maybe he deserved to be thrown out. I don't know, but I feel guilty.
Maybe I feel guilty. I can't take Jack's 10 grand without doing something to earn it first.
Why not? Why shouldn't a rabbi play at being detective? You want to investigate, Rabbi Stone? Be my guest.
I'll have to ask you some questions about what happened.
Can't you just ask the police?
They won't talk to me. I'm a suspect.
Fine. Ask whatever you want.
Achievement unlocked. Remain polite and civil. Get her on your side. Yay! Achievement Heflek? Heflek? I don't know what that means. I think they need to add some more words to the dictionary. Okay. First thing, how are you doing?
How are you holding up, Mrs. Lauder?
Fine. As well as can be expected.
You know, one thing I've noticed about this apartment here is it seems awfully sparse. As if they're moving or just moved in or something. Where's all the furniture? There's like a single chair at those huge windows. And just an empty floor. Ask about mirror. What? What mirror?
You've covered up the mirror.
Yes, it's what you are supposed to do, right?
Well, yes, but...
Oh.
I know. I'm not Jewish. I'm probably doing it all wrong, but it feels right. Is it right, Rabbi?
Hold on just a second, I'll be right back. Alright, I'm back. Well, I'm not going to be critical. I'm definitely not going to be critical. She's just trying to do right by her husband, so...
It's perfect.
Thank you.
Alright, how about the business?
What business was your husband in?
We were in business together. Fashion design. High-end casual wear. Shirts, blouses, slacks. I'd design and he'd sell.
Oh. That sounds nice. What was the name of the company?
What is the name of your business?
Charming Fashion Company.
Charming?
Yeah, it's a strange name, but it has meaning behind it. It's based on my family's name, Sharma. And it sounds like charming.
I get it. Real cute.
God, Russell is so cynical. Alright, well I just wrote it down so I can maybe search for it? On the computer? Maybe. Consult your notes. What is that? Let's do the other ones first. Where is the business?
Where is your showroom?
Why, do you want to have a look?
It can't hurt.
Oh, this is crazy. Do you really want to do this?
Yes.
Sure, if you want to have a look, go ahead. Just because trained police officers couldn't find anything doesn't mean a rabbi can't. The building is 1407 Broadway, room 903.
Okay, I probably don't need to write that down. It's just going to be another location on the map. How was the business doing?
Was the business successful?
We did all right. It was tough at first, but things have been picking up over the last few years. We sell to mainly boutique stores. But Macy's has bought several pieces from us, and Saks was interested.
What about the future?
And what happens to the business now? Are you going to run it by yourself?
I guess I could, but not right away. And definitely not in that same showroom.
I can understand that.
Now, what happened?
How did Jack die?
He was shot, right in the head, at close range, according to the police.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Lauder.
He was in the showroom, working late. That's all I know.
Shot in the head from point blank. So it was like an execution then. It sounds like an execution. Like someone knew exactly who they were going for and it wasn't, say, a robbery gone wrong. Consult your notes. What is this? Charming. What is that?
Can you tell me about your company again?
Sure. What do you want to know?
Okay, I guess it just brings you back here.
I'm going to leave now. I'll see what else I can discover.
Thanks. I guess. Rabbi Stone?
Yes?
About 8 years ago, could you just tell me why?
Were you and Jack happy?
Yes. Yes, we were.
Then my reasons don't matter.
Strange. Were you and Jack happy? Then my reasons don't matter. Why did he throw them out? I wonder if that's just a small plot point, and not particularly relevant, or maybe that goes to the heart of the whole thing. Well, let's go check out Charming Fashion.